Hi guys, I'm Sharif and welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I'm gonna share my knowledge behind Charminar and its construction. Before jumping into our topic, make sure you have subscribed to my channel, and for more interesting videos, hit that notification bell icon to get notified whenever I upload a video. So without any further ado, let's roll into our video. The Archaeological Survey of India, the current caretaker of the structure, mentions in its records, there are various theories regarding the purpose for which Charminar was constructed. However, it is widely accepted that Charminar was built at the center of the city to commemorate the eradication of cholera, a deadly disease that was spread wide at that time. Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah has prayed for the end of the plague that was ravaging his city and vowed to build a mosque at the very place where he prayed. According to Jean de Thévenot, a French traveler of the 17th century, whose narration was complemented with the available Persian text, the Charminar was constructed in the year 1591 to commemorate the beginning of the second Islamic millennium year. The event was celebrated far and wide in the Islamic world. Thus, Qutub Shah founded the city of Hyderabad to celebrate the event and commemorate it with the construction of this building. Due to its architecture, it is also called as Arc de Triomphe of the East. Historian Masood Hussein Khan says that the construction of Charminar was completed in the year 1592, and that is the city of Hyderabad, which was actually founded in the year 1591. According to the book Days of the Beloved, Qutub Shah constructed the Charminar in the year 1589 on the very spot where he first glimpsed his future queen Bhagmati. And after her conversion to Islam, Qutub Shah renamed the city as Hyderabad. Though the story was rejected by the historians and scholars, it became popular for folklore among the locals. Actually, the Charminar or the Four Minarets, constructed in 1591, is a monument and mosque located in Hyderabad, Telangana, India. The landmark has become a global icon of Hyderabad, listed among the most recognized structures of India. Charminar has become a historical place with mosque on top floor for over 400 years and also famous for its surroundings. It is one of the tourist attractions in Hyderabad, where many local festivals are celebrated in Charminar, like Ramzan. The Charminar is situated on the east bank of Musi River. To the west lies the Lad Bazaar, and to the southwest lies the richly ornamented granite Makkah Masjid. It is listed as an archaeological and architectural treasure of the official list of monuments prepared by Archaeological Survey of India. The English name is a translation and combination of the Urdu word Char and Minar, translating the four pillars. The eponymous tower are ornate minarets attached and supported by four grand arches. The fifth ruler of the Qutub Shahi dynasty, Sultan Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, built the Charminar after shifting his capital from Golconda to Hyderabad. Charminar has become a global and national landmark as well as a global icon of Hyderabad. The Charminar was constructed at the intersection of the historical trade route that connects the market of Golconda with the port city of Machilipatnam. The old city of Hyderabad was designed with Charminar as its centerpiece. The city was spread around the Charminar in four different quadrants and chambers segregated according to the established settlements. Towards the north of Charminar is the Char Kaman or Four Gateway, constructed in the cardinal direction. Additional eminent architects from Persia were also invited to develop the city plan. The structure itself was intended to serve as a mosque and madrasa. It is of Indo-Islamic architecture style, incorporating Persian architectural elements. The clock on the four cardinal direction was added in 1889. There is a wazoo in the middle with a small fountain for ablution before offering prayer in the Charminar Mosque. During the Mughal governorship between Qutub Shahi and Asif Jahi rule, the southwestern minarets fell to pieces after being struck by lightning and was repaired at a cost of ₹60,000. In 1824, the monument was replastered at a cost of ₹1 lakh. Qutub Shah was also among the early poets of Dakini Urdu. While laying the foundation of Charminar, he performed a prayer in Dakini couplets, which are recorded as follows. Fill the city of mine with people as you fill the river with fishes, O Lord. In our recent times, there is a project going on, which is a pedestrianization project. The Charminar pedestrianization project was instituted by the combined government of Andhra Pradesh in partnership with the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation. The project was initiated in 2006 with an investment of ₹35 crores. Out of ₹35 crores, the share of central government funds stood at ₹12.28 crores, while the state government gave ₹5.26 crores. However, the project did not see the light of day due various factors such as Telangana movement, illegal encroachments by hawkers, vehicular traffic, and illegal street vendors. Later, during January 2017, the new government of Telangana introduced a 14-member French delegation to take over the project to assess the feasibility in developing the monument as an eco-friendly tourism and heritage destination. The team has inspected surrounding areas such as the Gulzar House, Makkah Masjid, Lad Bazaar, and Sardar Mahal. Subsequently, the project took over on the brisk pace as is expected to be completed by May 2018. Okay guys, that's it for now. If you're interested to know more about this topic or related to this topic or any topic which you wanted to know, please hit onto the comment section below and let me know. Till then.